Well, it's Thursday, so it's time now for our weekly tech report. And boy, have we got a whopper for you. It's DEF CON week in Las Vegas. That is one of the oldest and biggest computer hacking conventions in the entire world. Here, anything with a circuit board or a chip or a SIM card or any electronic parts whatsoever are subject to hacking. This is where security researchers and cyber cracks, safe crackers and lockpicks and identity thieves and other digital enthusiasts gather to exchange ideas. RT's own cyber guru Andrew Blake is in Las Vegas to bring us a preview. Andrew, what can we expect to come out of DEF CON, this conference?
Hey, Megan, thank you very much. Well, so far, if this is any indication, around 15,000 hackers, triple-digit temperatures, and a bunch of fun and games. We got around another 4 days lined up, and people were there actually at 8 p.m. last night getting ready to get a nice spot at DEF CON, and things started to pick up this morning. There's only been a couple of presentations so far, but like you said, over the next couple of days, we're going to hear from all sorts of security experts, lock pickers, anyone involved in any sort of security consulting, information sciences, people who touch computers with any sort of degree, and anyone who can do something with technology to harness it, to make it better, to innovate, to invent. There's 15,000 of them. They're all here in Vegas, and they're all looking forward to having an interesting couple of days and to leave with some new knowledge.
And obviously, Andrew, this comes at a very important time. We're hearing so much about the NSA leaks and things like that. So can you tell me, how is the competition handling this? Obviously, the need for or the desire for privatized communication is bigger now than more than ever.
Oh, I mean, absolutely. And, you know, in the past, encryption and different ways of communicating with people over the internet, over the phone, these are topics that have always been discussed at DEF CON. But this year in particular, given the recent disclosures from Edward Snowden and what we learned about the NSA, people are especially interested this year. In fact, throughout the course of the convention, there's going to be a panel discussion with the Electronic Frontier Foundation and another with the American Civil Liberties Union, where they're going over what exactly these NSA leaks mean. This morning, even, there was a presentation, the first one of the entire convention, was about the federal laws that exist right now with regards to copyright, patent, because, you know, it's not just civil liberties that are at risk. There's all sorts of computer legislation, many which are outdated, that can provide a way for hackers to accidentally end up not necessarily on the radar of the federal government, but just in jail. It's one thing to have the NSA spying on you, but a lot of things that seem seemingly legal actually aren't. And that's why a lot of people come here, to learn more about how to be involved in this trade without risking a lengthy jail sentence or ending up on the bad side of the law.
And Andrew, I understand that the hackers were not alone at this conference. The head of the National Security Agency, Keith Alexander, made an appearance in Vegas to talk about what he does in the NSA in particular at the Black Hat Security Conference. What was his message and how did the audience receive him?
Oh, they did not receive him very, very well, actually. When General Alexander spoke yesterday, he was actually booed. He was jeered. There were obscenities that were yelled in his direction. He tried to defend PRISM. He tried to defend the leaked documents attributed to Mr. Snowden, which have really blown the cover of the NSA and explained exactly what many people have thought for decades now. I've already spoken to a handful of people this morning at the convention who it was one of the first things that they would mention was, well, you know, we're here right now because of what the NSA has been doing, and we need to find ways to make sure that we can still communicate freely. You know, just a few hours ago, I sat down with John Draper. He was a phone freak back in the 60s and 70s, one of the original real hackers, if you will. And he was going on and on about, well, you know, I've seen the NSA be doing these things since the 70s, and it's not good. He was telling me, you know, what he's had to do in the past in order to circumvent this stuff and what people have to do now. And, you know, here's someone who has been very involved in the community and pretty much said he was appalled by these disclosures. So people are going to be discussing them at length on the EFF, the ACLU discussions. But, you know, these are people who already specialize, many of the attendees specialize in encryption, specialize in security. So if you're not necessarily learning something new here, you're at least being able to network with other people who can help kind of bring this community a little bit more closely knit at a time when that's really imperative.
And as these people come together to discuss the future of cyber technology and hacking, you'll be discussing it with us, I'm sure. RT Web producer Andrew Blake reporting from Las Vegas.
Yeah, thanks, Megan.